Okay. The title of this song shall be Sling. It says right there.
And if you don't know what's going on, let it be tonight. I'll show you right.
I've actually been working on a song improvisation project intensively for the past 5 years, and I'm not quite where I want to be with it yet, but I've definitely learned some really interesting things along the way, and I kind of wanted to throw those at you now if you're interested. I'll be the first one to tell you, I have a lot to learn in all of this, so anyone who's got any ideas in terms of how to write songs faster, throw them in the comments. Let's make it a party. Number one thing that has opened up doors for me is learning to freestyle rap. I mean, I know for some people, this is going to be a little bit of a no-no. It's like rap is one of probably the top three hated genres of people. I mean, some people love it. Some people get it. Some people are just like, oh, that rap stuff. But I got to tell you, that's the number one piece that most people are missing, is being able to make up lyrics on the spot. And freestyle rappers are the best at it, probably in history that I'm aware of. So I just created a course about how to learn to freestyle rap. I strongly recommend you check it out. It's free. It's a method I kind of developed myself. It works really well for me. It might work for you too, but if you want to make up songs really quickly or write songs really quickly, freestyle rapping, literally the best thing I think you can do. The next best thing I think you can do is learn lots of songs in one style. There's a lot of things you can do with theory, but theory by itself is not going to make this happen for you. But if you're lucky, you might be one of those people who can just learn a bunch of songs and then learn how to make up songs based on that. And there's literally nobody who can learn how to make up songs really well without having some kind of basis that they're coming from. And I heard someone say one time that their band got to be a really solid band when they knew 300 songs. And I think I went over all the bands I'd been in, all the projects I've done over the past 5 years, and realized, yeah, I learned about, you know, especially in the past 3 years when I was doing bands, I learned about 300 songs and played out with a lot of those bands. And I started to see my ability to write in the styles of those bands really emerged after I learned maybe, you know, 50 or so songs in that style. And the only thing I regret is that I didn't focus more. So it's like, man, numbers in your personal repertoire, huge. Numbers in one very focused area, even better. The next most important thing I found, and this is huge, is develop like modules or templates of sound or just like patterns that you get into that you can just snap up really quick. I think watching Jacob Collier record on his iHeartMU series, you see it very clearly, but for me, the most useful thing I ever did was I took one particular artist I liked, his name is DubFX. I literally learned as many of his songs as I could, and I really tried to understand the pattern that he created his songs with. And you know, since I did that, I really learned how to improvise textures for songs in that style like really quickly. You can literally give me anything and I can make up a texture in his style virtually instantaneously because I just know that pattern from having taken his songs apart. And that has gotten me through so many pickles in terms of, you know, not only just creatively improvising in shows, but also in terms of writing really quickly. So anything you can do that with is great. Pro tip, you want the easiest texture to learn in the entire world? Ukulele songs in the key of C. The next most important thing I think you can do is practice disinhibiting yourself. And I do not mean with liquid courage, if you know what I'm talking about. Your ability to kind of let loose and kind of get into a zone, that's a trained thing. No matter how much you think to yourself, I should be comfortable with this, I should be comfortable around these people, you're not going to be able to do it unless you really just push yourself to be comfortable and to kind of flow freely. And it's something you have to just practice with whatever you do. So any kind of improvising or writing that you do, it's like getting in the habit of getting yourself just in total dump mode. I mean, just believing and knowing in your heart that the people who create the best stuff almost always have this ability to just free write open up the faucet, whether it's with a guitar solo or with writing verses to songs. Again, going back to the freestyle rapping thing, you just turn a switch on where whatever it is you're doing, you know, creating drum beats or creating lyrics or anything, you just let it out. You don't judge it. You know, people always say write drunk, revise sober. I don't mean that literally, but it's kind of metaphorical in the sense that getting really comfortable with whatever those modules I was talking about before, whatever it is you do, you just let it flow totally freely, and then you go back and reflect on it later. That is absolutely critical to this process. Another really critical thing to do is work on your workflow. I mean, having too much gear is like just a curse that everybody who does music these days seems to deal with, because you can make music on your phone, but then you've got, you know, six guitars and, you know, two computers that don't work. And it's like streamlining the gear that you have and the gear that you work with and getting intimately familiar with what you are doing, with the process you do have, is really critical. So figuring out kind of like what your deal is. I mean, again, if I go back to like my DubFX thing, you know, it's a very kind of clear setup. I knew exactly what gear I was using. I knew exactly what sections were going on to the song, but now if I strip myself down to I have a guitar, a microphone, and this looper that I work with now I work with the Boss RC300 a lot, you know, I can do a great deal with just that because I've worked with that flow quite a bit. I know those instruments, I know what kind of parts I can do, I know what kind of parts I like to do, I know what types of song pieces I tend to put on each track of the looper, given different processes. And, you know, I mean, I've done a lot of stuff like naming my cables. I mean, just, you know, spending just some time, just, you know, getting intimately familiar with your gear, man, that really makes things flow much more smoothly. Another thing that's really, really helpful to do is what I call abstraction exercises. And this is really just to get your brain unstuck. I mean, a lot of people will do all the things I just talked about and they're still just stuck. And one big thing a lot of people get stuck on is not being able to think about what they're doing abstractly, or only being able to spit out things they've already taken in. And a lot of that just goes back to just starting to play with the stuff you know. I mean, the easiest way to think of it is like, what, you know, with a scale. If you want to start to improvise your melodies, which is, of course, going to let you generate material quicker, you want to figure out, okay, well, how do I do that? Well, first thing is just figure out what the bloody scale you're working is, and, you know, figure out what the notes are, and just play the notes in random orders. And I mean, just like play with them. That's an abstraction exercise. You can do that with rhythm too. Well, here are the beats I can land on. Well, you know, what if I landed on this beat? What if I landed on this beat? It's just a what if. These are the things I have to play with. Then just play with them. Once you start to loosen up the gears with that, all kinds of stuff can start to happen. But until you can kind of get loose with whatever module or songwriting tool you're working with, a lot of times those things can't happen. So do those abstraction exercises if you feel stuck. Another really good thing to do is develop your own little games you play with yourself. And these can be literally anything. You can steal them from other people. It really doesn't matter. But these are there to kind of get you into a creative flow. One example that I kind of stole from a John Mayer vlog not too long ago is he had this video he called Muso-Regurgitative Songwriting. And I guess I call it Franken-stemming. You know, a lot of times when I start writing songs with people and I don't have a lot of time, I need to just kind of make a mashup basically as quick as I can. So my formula is really simple. I get them to come up with three songs that they like, any three songs, and I'm gonna take their favorite element of each one. There's the lyrics from this, there's a guitar texture from this, and there's a weird plot idea from this. And I'll just figure out how to, you know, they'll play those songs for me, I'll get them right away, I don't have to wait to generate ideas, I don't get any writer's block. I take those ideas, I figure out what would they be like if you just overlapped them. Really quickly, you get into an entirely new sounding musical space, and then you can kind of tweak things from there. You can say, at that point, you can say, oh, I don't like how the beat of that needs to be faster, or, you know, I think this needs an extra verse. But once you've just sort of rammed a bunch of things together, you know, you can do that really quickly without thinking about it too much, and it will help you start to feel if you're getting close or not. And that process is really easy, really, really quick. That's a game I like to play. Gets me in a creative flow and gets me writing with people just like that. Kind of stemming off of that, if you want to develop your own games, the most important thing is setting limitations. And a lot of people who are creative are like, man, I don't want to limit myself. But of course, anyone who's done this a lot realizes if you don't limit yourself, you go crazy. So figuring out what to get rid of, what instruments to get rid of, putting a time limit on yourself, saying I'm only going to write in this genre, I'm only going to, you know, write things that have this structure. Just limiting yourself for a while so you can not only get better at your different modules, as it were, but you can get into more of a creative flow. That's a really key thing. So just experiment with taking things away. What if I wasn't allowed to use this? What if I only had this available, you know, for this video? I was like, what if I literally have my looper and a ukulele? That's it, you know? It works really well. The other secret sauce that I came, and the last little tip I'll give you is, watch people who make up songs, you know, or even any part of songs. I mean, anyone has seen, you know, Slash or B.B. King do a guitar solo, that's good. Watch them and see if that can kind of snap you into that improvisational mode. Because a lot of times just watching someone do this stuff snaps you into the right mode. You just see what they do and how they use what they have. And you realize, I have that too, and you just start using it in that way. In the links below, I've got a whole bunch of things that I watched that really kind of helped me with my song improvisation and my rapid songwriting. I think the guy who first got me really into it was Andrew Huang. His channel is just loaded with this stuff. It's super great. And he also really has this prolific mindset, which I think is really helpful. But I think for me, the most profound shift came when I watched Jacob Collier do his I Harm You live streams. I mean, just watching this guy record, because he's so fast and so good at it, it's just like, first of all, it got me really excited about doing my own things. But it also helped me see, what does this look like when you do it really well? And you can almost start to picture yourself doing what they're doing. And over the years, I saw a lot of things that really helped. Watching Devin Townsend record a song in 2 hours, that was really great. I saw a video where Virtual Riot did a dubstep drop in 10 minutes. I've watched freestyle rap battles. I've watched this classical music that everyone calls her like the Mozart girl. I can't remember her name, I'll link it below. But you know, someone gave her 4 notes and she did a Mozart style improvisation. I've seen Ann Hampton Calloway improvise songs. And you know, some of these come out really good, some of them come out really bad. But you know, some of my takes for the intro to this video came out really bad. But you know, truth is, it really doesn't matter. 90% of what you come up with is going to be garbage anyway. And that's okay, because the 10% that is good is going to happen totally serendipitously. And you know, you being willing to throw yourself at it is what's going to let you get there. So have a little faith, let go, don't worry about it, have fun with it. That's a lot of what makes this enjoyable to do. It's just letting go and getting into a spontaneous state and just letting stuff happen. If you all are into this rapid songwriting thing, or you want to get into more of these techniques I'm working with, consider subscribing to me on Patreon, because that's what kind of supports me doing more advanced levels of any of the ideas that I throw out there. You should also really consider maybe like one of the collaborative student options, where you can work with me and we can kind of create more techniques for rapid songwriting together. And another thing, I have another video after this about how to make your songs matter to people. I've done a lot of writing for people and with people with very kind of specific purposes in mind. And kind of exploring that will give you a little bit of an answer to the question, well, so I can write songs. Well, so what? You know, it's really exploring what about songwriting really matters to people and how to make your songs more valuable to you and to other people worth exploring. So yeah, hope you dig all that stuff, and yeah, deuces, Yuns.